Hey YouTube, it's your boy Bobby, and I have finally, I'm giving you guys what I originally started the whole Bobby channel for, and that was to show you guys the treatment. Later, used to be called the technique. It is a technique, but is your treatment for synthetic units to extend the life of them. So, you know, there's been a few videos before this where I show you how to wash and condition, how to, on a daily, maintain the straightness of your straight synthetic units with the blow dryer. I do that every night before I go to sleep. I try and do it every night before I go to sleep. Not the first few nights after I do my treatment, because the treatment is so good that it doesn't need it. Then I show you how to make a template, which makes your installation so much quicker, so much easier. Then I show you how to install with the template. So I show you how to make the template, how to install with the template. I show you how to wash and condition. I show you how to sleep in your videos. But this is the video that I have been just so trying to get out there. Yay, finally! So, without further ado, here is the video that I know I've been waiting for. I hope you have too.
All right, first off, guys, I was going through a really bad breakout when I was shooting this video, so excuse my chin and stuff. But this is the unit. You see it's looking kind of stiff. It's not the worst example of a bad unit, but it is a pretty, it's not acceptable. I mean, it's acceptable for maybe a day or two like that, but after that is going to cause you some issues and some trouble that and some headache that you don't want. I mean, as I was trying to say here, the unit right now, it's not bad. It's not in the worst condition. It could be a whole lot worse. This is still passable. This is still workable. This is still actually kind of gorgeous, but because it's so long, but after this,
it's going to be silky all the way through.
So I kind of try to get a close up here. The ends is what kills it for me. Like when ends start looking chewy,
they're a little bit chewy to me. As it goes up, it kind of smooths out and gets smoother and smoother as it gets to the roots. But we're gonna make this whole unit completely smooth all the way to roots to end. So this is the before.
But wait, guys, soon will be the after.
The moment you've all been waiting for. The technique. Now, these are the tools that I use in the beginning. My brush, my fine-tooth comb,
and a little magic.
So these two things. This brush is old, but it does the job. And a fine-tooth comb. These two things, coupled with the secret ingredient. Yes, it's an iron. It is an iron, a regular old iron with a huge surface. So you know what a huge surface means? Lots of coverage done in one pass. And not only that, it's something about the way the fibers grip to this on one side and being pressed with the iron on the other side that just gets your unit together like that. Like that, guys, I'm trying to tell you. You want to put your setting on either polyester or nylon. Now, polyester or rayon. The highest that I've been able to go with an iron is rayon. On this particular unit, I can sit on rayon. My last unit, I could only put on polyester before I could tell it was melting the fire. So I had to set on rayon. And you can see that. Just set on rayon. And it will stop blinking when it's heated up enough. And you want to go ahead and turn the unit inside out. So you want to get it from the inside and just... And then I've also made it so that the back is on this side and the front is on this side. Okay? So then you take it. Let's see. I'm going to do the front first. It's wet. It's a little bit damp for me. Rinsing out the conditioner. I'm gonna take my comb. At this point, you can tangle it. You can make it look all raggedy. All right. So maybe you want to go ahead and
go ahead and get the big tangles out with a bigger comb or brush. So I have my big paddle brush that I'm going to, yeah, the handle broke off, I was part with it. So I'm just gonna brush out these tangles starting primarily at the end. I'm gonna give those just a nice, it's like ironing a shirt, guys. It really, really is. So it takes, as long as it takes you to set up your iron and comb this out, but the magic, oh my gosh, that it performs. All right, so, you know, it doesn't matter how thick it is, because you're gonna flip it over to the other side, to the other side. So I have this combed out with my brush, or brush out with my brush. Then I'm gonna take my fine tooth comb and just make sure that I got the tangles out. There we go. And then, probably use my rayon setting. And I'm just gonna iron it, like an iron shirt. But I'm gonna start, at first I'm going to, oh, one thing I forgot. So you do want a weight holding this side down. So I have my big ass paperweight. Because when I'm combing it, the comb is going to pull at the unit. So I don't have to hold this down when I'm combing it because the paperweight is holding it down. So I'm gonna take my iron and chase the comb with the iron. But first, I would actually just go ahead and just iron it like normal without before the comb. With this whole side done in minutes. You can even see the sheen, the shine, just from these few passes that I did. So now I'm gonna take the comb and chase it, follow it. And you know, sometimes I have the brush, because it's a little, you know, the boy's hair brush is fine. It gets a little bit of more, it separates the hairs a little bit better.
Okie dokie, guys. So, as you can see, I speeded up this side. I don't think I'm saying too much important in this part. And it's basically simple. So I got this kind of speeded up for you guys.
We've got a long way to go. When snow hits the asphalt, cold looks and bad talk come. We've got a long way to go. It's beyond Martin Luther. Upgrade computer.
All right, so for the rest of the video, it's basically me ironing the unit, and I iron it with a boar's hair brush because it gets it really untangles it because the bristles are so, you know, in depth and fine. So I do the front, then I flip it over to the back side, and when I flip it over to the back side, I start at the nape, and I show you guys how frizzy it kind of still was at the nape of the neck. But by me ironing the front side first, it kind of worked out some of the frizz on the back side. So I tried to speed this up for you guys. This was as fast as my thing will let me go, but maybe I can make it go a little bit faster. Alright guys, so I just flipped the unit over, or I'm about to flip the unit over and hit the backside of it. Now the backside had a little bit of frizz that was kind of ironed out for me doing the front side of it, and I am going to show you guys that. But the iron takes that frizz completely out. There I am talking about it. I am wishing I could speed this up more, guys, but I don't have time to trigger and figure out how to do that. This is as fast as I could get it to go, but there's the frizz I was talking about. And the iron, like I said, had already, when I did the front side, taken that frizz out. Most of it, for the most part. But when I go over it again on the back side with the iron, it completely irons it out. It pretty much makes the unit, like, brand new. I mean, I love this technique. I would recommend it for any unit. Yeah, this is my go-to for ironing out or straightening out a straight unit. I don't know about curly units. I haven't worked with them, so I can't tell you. But this, however, can work from the most matted unit, straight unit that you have. Just take the, you know, pre-steps as far as washing and conditioning the unit, which you can find any tutorial about. I even have a tutorial about it where you wash the unit with it on. So that means, you know, the unit has to be, for you to still be wearing it, the unit has to be in pretty good shape. But there's that gloss, there's that frizz completely gone. I could have hit it a little bit more with the iron, but I didn't. So I am so happy with this. Like I said, you can use this to the most matted, nappy. You don't have to cut your units anymore, guys. You don't have to cut off those frizzy ends. All you have to do is untangle them completely and then get the iron. Make sure you put it on that low setting of polyester to rayon or nylon. I forget which one. I know I said it in the video, but it's either the polyester setting or the next setting after that. So there I am, finished with the unit, guys, and now I'm going to let me speak from the doona, because I just go on and on about how beautiful it is. So here we go. Can you see that? Can you see that? Can I mean, you saw how, God, the sun is bleaching it out. So there we go. So smooth all the way to the end. So this is what your unit will look like. My technique. And that is so much easier than doing the straight iron. I mean, and this process took me 5 to 8 minutes at max to do. So there you have it, guys. Look at that, that's gorgeous. That's gorgeous! Look at that, I'm so happy! So this will last me with my blow drying technique. This will last a week. If I wear it every single day, like I do. Like I didn't go to sleep with this one last night, clearly, but I mean, I really wish you guys could be here to see this, because it is just, it's a new unit. Like, it's a brand new unit. Like, this is... So, clearly, I am super stoked about how my technique worked and how it showed on film, and it's just great. I'm happy. I'm stoked. Awesome! I just can't get over how.
I just want to do another shot of this because it is so gorgeous.
Great. My technique makes a unit.
I mean, look at that.
Dude. And that means any unit.
Look
so.
Look at that.
I'm just gonna let this sink in, guys. The rest of the video is just me showing off.
I did not spend
unit.
Hours.
I put it on and everything. Like, so go ahead and watch.
What, 5-10 minutes is like iron? That was an iron, and that was just me talking. If I was in a rush, baby, trust and believe, I would have got through. I would have had that unit ironed out in about 5 minutes.
Sit up and watch it just unravel like that. You better work.
I just took it out of that ponytail and. I mean, there's a sound. Look at that. You can't help but get into that. Come on now. I'm just saying. Hey guys, so this is your boy Bobby, and I just wanted to give an update. This is day number 4. This is day number 4, guys. Wait, is it 4 or 5? Oh, I lost track. It's Thursday. So, I did it, I think, Sunday. So, that would make it day number 4 with my treatment of my synthetic, and still looking good. I'll show you the back. I decided to try and do a lot of my tutorials in natural sunlight. So, day number 4, 5. Need I say more?
You got style.
Thank you guys. Thank you for watching. I hope that the content was something that you got some use out of. I am happy to get that out there. It's been fun shooting these tutorials, and I would appreciate some comments, guys. I haven't been getting any, so go ahead and shoot a comment down here if you watch it, if it was good, if you liked it, if it sucked or whatever. But, you know, give me a thumbs up or thumbs down. Just give me some kind of feedback. All right, guys. And if you like, subscribe. So take care.